Hi, welcome to Guy's Art Studio. Today I'm going to paint a watercolour painting, a cockerel. I met a lady the other day called Vera and she'd bought one of my paintings, a hen painting, and loved it so much she's asked me to paint a cockerel to go along with it. It's a Rhode Island red cockerel and I hope you enjoy it. Here's a picture of the hen painting that Vera bought. Hi, so this is a tracing of the painting that I have done of one of titled Mad Hen, which is a hen Rhode Island red. The lady Vera's asked me to paint a picture of a cockerel that will go alongside it, so size is quite important. Although the cockerel's normally bigger than a hen, I believe she wants the painting to match and look similar, so I'm going to paint the cockerel the same size as the hen. I guess it could be further away, so that doesn't really matter. Anyway, the pictures need to match, need to look like they go together. So this is a size. What I'm going to do is, I'm pretty sure we've got pencil both sides of this. So I need to look at a photo actually, see which way round I did it. Can't remember whether it's that way. I think it's that way. So the painting I've done is this way round. I'm going to paint the cockerel that way round. Although I'm not using the same tracing identically, I'm going to just put a couple of marks on the paper just to get the rough size so that I know where I'm going with the size of it. So, yeah, that's good. I've got some marks on the paper. This is just a rough piece of paper. This is fresh for me. I've not drawn this painting before. I've not painted this painting before. So you're seeing the whole process as we go through, how I work it out and how I construct the image of the cockerel and how I put it down and hopefully end up with a good painting at the end of it. So I've got an image of a Rhode Island red cockerel. I'm not going to copy it, but I was just using it to see shapes and forms, just rough ideas of how I'm going to construct this animal, this bird. So we're going to just do this quite quickly, really. So I'm going to have. Head's going to be about here. So what I tend to do these round shapes, and some people don't like them. I make this sort of circles and sausage shapes just to get that rough idea. You've got quite a prominent chest. They're powerful birds, these cockerels. It reminds me of one recently actually. I'm in a drumming group called Pentacle Drummers, and once a year we go down to Stonehenge campsite and do a bit of drumming down there, and there was a cockerel at this farm. It's pretty terrifying, to be honest, the way it was charging around. Pretty terrifying. Everyone was wary of it. It actually attacked a couple of people. Drew. Right, you can't actually see too well what I've done there. So what I'm going to do, just go over it with, I've got 7B here. I'm going to go over and just show you what I've done. So basically there's a circle of the head, circle of the chest, kind of how I start, do something like that, and then the painting or the drawing is going to evolve from there. So look at the style of what I've done before. So one picture that I'm looking at as inspiration, the cockerel is looking in this direction with his mouth open, a bit like that. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to change it around. I'm going to have the eyes looking forward. Not sure how to do those yet. Beak looking forward. Be doing something like that. We'll change it up. Bit on the top there, whatever it's called. I'm sure someone's going to message in and tell me what that bit's called. I can Google it. So, put some harder lines in now. So I haven't drawn this before, this is winging it. I suppose that's a joke. If I'm drawing a wing. So yeah. Very little if no preparation done. It may show in this video. Too much detail in here, but what I do want to be able to understand what I'm painting when I start, shall we say, throwing the paint on. got some shapes in there drawn. Quite a bit of a crazy stance on there. Hopefully it looks like a cockerel. Just need to look at his face, see what I can do about that. I've got the original chicken's face that I've drawn, I suppose. I can model him a bit on that. Which I think I might do. I'll tie the pictures together, won't it? So I think the head looks a bit big on that. Cockerel's face look like, let's have a look. So I think I'm there with it. I'm just rubbing out a few bits that I don't want, and I'll just then see whether I'm happy with this rough image of what I've got. Basically, the picture of the hen that I painted had a lot of character. I had a lot of fun painting that picture, and I didn't want to paint the regular sort of standard sort of chicken, really, or hen. I wanted to paint something.
painting that was a bit of fun, made you laugh a little bit when you looked at it, evoked a few emotions. I think painting should do that. It should evoke emotion when you look at it. If you want to hold someone looking at the painting, you've got to create an atmosphere, some sort of emotion, something that makes them laugh, makes them stand back and go, ooh, I don't know about that, you know, something to talk about it. Maybe a bit shocking sometimes, the picture, the painting. A bit thought provoking. Anyway, so what I'm doing now is I'm rubbing out some marks that basically just sketch marks and doodle marks. I'm going to try and be left with pretty much what I want to put in the painting. So, as I say, this is the process of painting a watercolour painting. You don't, well, I mean, sometimes you just throw the paint on the canvas or on the paper. But most of the time, a painting has gone through many steps of thought processes and just concentration and working out what you're going to end up with. You can have happy accidents, of course you can, especially with watercolour. You can have happy accidents with acrylic as well and oils, depending on how you put the paint on. But even with the painting with happy accidents in it, the painting's been worked out. There's been a route through the painting, a process. I'm quite happy with that. So what I'm going to do now is something I do quite often, all the time actually. Something I do all the time. I'm going to take a photo of what I've just drawn. I'm going to look at it, because sometimes you just see something different in the photograph that you don't see strangely with your eyes, just looking at what you've done. Yeah, I like that. It looks like a proud sort of cockerel, looking after his hens. Yeah, I like that. I'm happy with that. Or maybe not. I see something. So I've just seen something in the photograph that I don't like. And I don't know whether you call them. Are they waffles? This piece here is just not big enough. So I have another piece hanging down here, so I'm going to kick it out of it. That's better. No, it's not. They're all going the same way. That is okay. What I need to do, that one needs to go in a different direction or be a different shape. That's a bit bigger. Yeah, that's a bit better. See how they're all going to the right. In fact, that still wants changing. I don't think they can't be the same. Just isn't right to do that. So sometimes things were a little bit too samey. Is that a word? Was a little bit too samey. So we need to change it up sometimes and make sure that they're not. I've just gone straight in and done that again. My brain wants to do that for some reason. Happy now. Yeah, happy with that. So what I'm going to do now, we're going to get a bit of paper on the board. I'm not going to bother to stretch it. I don't usually stretch paper. I've gone through a lot of process of stretching paper and not stretching paper. And had several nightmares trying to pull bits of paper off of boards where they've stuck to the boards where the glue's moved around. So yeah, a few nightmares with that. So what I tend to do now is I'm just going to paint on the paper. Yes, it's going to buckle a little bit, and then what I'm going to do afterwards is straighten the paper. There's a video on my channel, it's only a quick one, on how to flatten out your watercolor paintings once you've painted them. Basically, I suppose you're stretching them out. That's stretching them out after you've painted it, as opposed to doing it before. So, for me, that works better. I need to trace what I've just drawn out, draw on the back of the tracing, and then transfer it onto my watercolour paper. So, let's do that. What can happen when you go over this is you end up looking at it and then just adjusting it a little bit more. So sometimes leaving marks out is just as important as putting them in. So there's a gap there, there's a couple of gaps there. You don't want to fill it all in. Stance of the legs, so I've kept the stance of the legs the same as the hen to obviously tie it together as a pair. So what I'm doing, as you can see, I'm changing it up. Got the image that I like, but all the time you go through the process, you just affecting it, you're just adjusting it just a little bit. There's some little bits you like, there's some little bits you don't like, and I guess that's part. part of the process. Right, so what we're gonna do now, I'm just gonna look, yeah, I was doing the drawing with a 7B pencil so you could see it, because sometimes when you draw, it doesn't show up on the camera. So, but what I need to do now, just need to find a HB. This one. So I've got a HB pencil, I'm gonna draw over the top again, transfer it to a watercolor paper. Again, what's going to happen when I do this, I'm not going to draw over all of the lines. What you've got to do is make sure you get the key points. So, I've just got a normal household brush here. Looks like a 1.5 inch decorating brush. Just going to roughly go in and paint. A little bit of wet on wet just for the background. Careful with it. A little careful, not too careful. We're going to get this on as quick as we can. So, quite a subtle background, not going in for any drama in the background. Owe it to my dad and my nan. Where I'll get my skills from. Okay, so I'm going to put a little bit more water on there. Because I'm happy with that. I've got to get his hairs out. Get them out. dryer out and dry it. Okay, so there you go. Background colours on. It's pretty subtle. The painting that I've done on of the hen was pretty subtle, so we're keeping it the same. Pieces. Just whatever you feel, really. A bit here, a little bit there. Dropping it in to some of the bits that have water on already. Thank you. I've just obviously going to change colours now. I've gone away from the greens and I'm going to the browns and the yellows and the reds of the cockerel. So I've changed my water. I don't want to add any green into my water when I'm doing that. Thank you. just dropping in water and dropping in. So I'm dropping in the water of the shape that I want to fill. And then I'm dropping in the colour over the top. So lighter colour first and then a bit of dark as well. So this has got to be a bit thicker, this paint. Picking out bits and pieces. Cockerel's got some lovely colours in it. Just following my pencil line a little bit more closely. Thank you. So it's time to now take another photo. And I'll have a look at that and see how we're getting on. Yeah, I think I'm happy with that. Job done, I think.
Hi, well, that was my watercolour of the Red Rooster that I've painted for somebody else, a commission. I hope you've enjoyed watching me paint that from start to the finish, the drawing, the working out what I was going to do, what I was going to paint. As I say, I haven't painted that picture before. I haven't drawn that picture before. So you saw me, the whole film is you seeing me work out what I'm going to do, doing a rough sketch and then turning it into a watercolour. And basically you can use that principle on anything at all. So I'll just run through the colours if you're interested. We've got cadmium red, cadmium orange, carillion hue, Prussian blue, ultramarine, burnt sienna, light red, crimson alizarin, leaf green and sap green. Don't forget, press like, press subscribe if you haven't already, and please share as well. Share to other people that might be interested, because the more people get to watch the videos, the better. So thank you very much and see you soon.